Valerijs Nits Kopets spēles pret Rīga FC treneru. Tavs komentārs.
Nu, atkal pievila ātrie vārti, ielaistie. Jā, un, protams, kārtojo reizē sāku, jā, tā kā pret RFS mums tā spēle bija. Jā. Nu, grūti jau tad spēles plāns mums vienkārši tad sabruka. Jā. Vieni, pēc tam uzreiz otrie. Jā. Bet paldies vismaz komandai, ka otrajā puslaika jā, atradam sev spēkos un tomēr nu, jau to otro puslaiku pavadījām cienīgāk. Jā. Tomēr nu, 2-1, ne 0-4. Jā. Salīdzinot. Bet tā, nu, jaunie spēlētāji, jaunus, kuri jaunākie izgāja, jā, protams, nu, jāpierot pie šitiem atrumiem, ir tīpaši tagad tur Eirokausi, jā, priekšā var redzēt, tā mums līdzīgi kā pret RFS. Jā, tur, nu, tagad var redzēt, ka gan Rīga, gan RFS ir optimālajā formā, jā, Eirokausi, jā, tomēr to var redzēt, jā, visi ļoti daudz atrāk, jā, agresīvāk, nu, mēs, protams, netiekam līdz.
Vai pirms spēles arī saprati, ka plus mīnus tāds varētu būt mača scenārijs, mača ritējums?
Nu, nē, arī cerējam uz to, ka ja neielaidīsim tos atros vārtus, nu, tad nu, daudz tas varētu noritēt tā, kā aptuveni pirmā spēle pret Rīgu, kad mēs 0-2. Jā, tur arī iespējas vajag daudziem, bet tomēr nu, 0-2. Okay, vai nu, kā pret RFS mēs nospēlējam, kad 1-2 zaudējam. Nu, cerējam uz kaut kādu tādu spēli aptuveni. Bet es saku, atrie vārti vienmēr visu, nu, no kājām uz galvu visu nolika.
Vai saprati, ka ar šiem ātriem vārtiem izveidojas tā situācija, kad pārkāp noteikumus ar loko savā sodlokumā?
Nu, nevajadzēja. Protams, cilvēks ar muguru pret vārtiem mūsējiem, jā, varbūt pat vajadzēja tur esat. Bet es saku, nu, tur arī tur komanda, nu, cerēja, mūsu komanda cerēja uz to labāko, jā, un tomēr svaigi vēl agresija tāda, nu, drusiņ emocijas varbūt nesavaldīja loko, ja kaut kur gribēja to tomēr bumbu dabūt. Protams, Rīga to izmantoja, ja ļoti gudri izbakstīja bumbu un pārkāpums, no ko darīt.
Otrajā puslaikā bez gūtiem vārtiem vēl daži ļoti labi momenti, jau sākot ar to, kas bija puslaika pirmajās sekundēs. Ar ko tas varēja saistās tavuprāt?
Nu, labi momenti kā maiņas, protams. Nu, daudz svaidzināja. Nu, grūti, kad laukuma tur ir vairāki spēlētāji 0-4 pēc pirmā puslaika, cerējot uz, nu, uz drusciņu citu iznākumu, pēc pirmā puslaika 0-4 grūti. Un, protams, tā emocionāli, protams, pirmam kartam tas svaigums atnāca no emocionālais, jā, pēc pirmā puslaika ar maiņam. Nu, un dēļ tā arī, jā, tie čaļi, kuri vēl maz spēlējuši virslīgu, protams, viņi mēģināja sevi parādīt no labākas puses.
Vai nav tā, ka arī šiem jauniem čaļiem Skonto stadionā kaut kāda papildus iedusma parādās?
Bet tas visiem ir. Gan treneriem tas no vecuma baigi nav atkarīgs. Nu, protams, spēlējot nu, tur pirmajā stadionā jā, Latvijā, nu, protams, citas emocijas, tribīnes, līdzjūtēji, jā, tā atmosfēra nu, ļoti ietekmē.
Varam ejot šodien pirmo reizi spēlēja virslīgā pēc atgriešanās. Jā, viņš bija arī kausā, pastāstīja, kādā formā, cik ilgi viņš ar komandu ir šobrīd.
Nu, it kā nebūtu braucis prom nekur tā, nu, ieju tas komandu uzreiz, jā, tā kā vienīgais tā fiziska forma, nu, var redzēt drusciņ, jā. Drusciņ vēl viņam jāuzņem to formu, tomēr pauze viņam bija diezgan lielā, jā, bet tā mēs vienalga uz viņu ceram, tā ar tu uz to agresiju, jā, var uzreiz redzēt, ka, nu, tas kvalitātes viņam ir, gan agresija, gan runašana laukuma, jā, tas palīdz.
Cik sāpīgs bija tos zaudējums Latvijas kausā pret tiešo konkurenti virslīgā Liepājā?
Nu, ļoti sāpīgs. Ļoti sāpīgs, ko tur var teikt. Ja? Arī, kā mums tur tā spēle ir tīpaši, nu, kad 2-1 it kā kausa spēle un atkal 3-1, atkal mums noliež pie zemes piespiedi, ja? Atkal 3-2, it kā atkal cerība un atkal ātrie vārti. Ja? Nu, tur mēs drusi nesapratām, ka mēs spēlējam kausā un ka, ja aizsardzība mums klibo kausa spēle, tad cerēt kausā nav uz ko. Ja? Tad pa lielam nu, kausa spēles uzvar aizsardzības. Ja? Var neielaist un aiziet tālāk. Ja? Tā kā tā.
Vai klubā iekšēji ir kaut kādas priedzes saistībā ar to, ka tagad ir tikai virsliga palikusi, cīņa par neizkrišanu, cik daudz, varbūt, nezinu, pētāt jau konkurentu kalendārus, tur tās spēles?
Nu, mums tas priedze, var teikt, no pirmas kartas. Tas priedze mums negaja nost. Jā, atrodoties visu laiku uz pēdējās vietas robežas, jā, nu visu laiku tā. Nu, ļoti grūti kaut ko. Katra spēle tu cer uz kaut ko. Jā, kā jāiet, jādabu punktus, jā, viņi ļoti grūti atnāk tie punkti. Jā, nu, nu spriegums ir, protams. Varbūt mēs paši sev to izdaram, to spriegumu. Nu, tīri emocionāli prasam no sevis. Tā galva. Nu, parasti tā ir, pēc zaudījumiem tu atjaunojies sliktāk. Jā, pēc, jā, ir uzvaras, nu, tad daudz savādāk tas viss. Jā, atjaunošana un emocijas citas, bet sāku tā spriedze, nu, viņu... Pa lielu mums katra spēle tas spriedze ir. Un tas kļūdas cena ir nu, lielā.
Redzu, ka komandai arī pieteikumā pievienojies Antons Dresmanis, kurš jau bija pieteikts iepriekšējiem mačiem, un arī viens Ukraiņu spēlētājs transfera sarakstā parādās. Varbūt pastāsti par šiem spēlētājiem ar kādu mērķi, ko viņi var iedot komandai, kā viņi jūtas šobrīd?
Nu, pirmkārt, vairāk mēs skatāmies uz tām emocijām, uz kaut kādām kvalitātēm, tāpēc, ka nu, Dresmanis jau iepriekš bija ar mums komanda, nu, es zinu, kā viņš tur treniņos uzvedās, jā, kā viņš var tur tos emocijas iedot, jā, arī agresiju kaut kā, tāpēc, ka, nu, var redzēt, arī šodien spēlē pirmajā puslaika, nu, it kā ļoti labi mēs izvietojamies divas līnijas, skaisti, kompakti, bet kaut kādos brīžos, jā, tur tie zaudījumi viens pret viens situācijas, nu, šito mums trūkst. Jā, ja taktiski kaut kas tie pārvietojumi ir ok, tad, kad aiziet līdz individuālai kaut kādai taktikai, tad pārādās problēmas.
Un par Ukraiņu spēlētāju varbūt vairāk pateikt?
Ko? Nu, centra pussargs, jā. Nu, mēģināsim jau pārbaudīt viņu nākošajās spēlēs. Arī viņš ilgu laiku, man liekas, tur no jauna gada nekas nav spēlējies. Tā kā, nu, ko? Centra pussargs, redzēsim. Kad sāks spēlēt, tad redzēsim. Bet tā, nu, kvalitātes ir, jā. Tādas, kādas mums vajag, jā, centra.
Simon, vēl kādī pēc spēles pret Jelgavu. Coach, first of all, your comment about this match.
Yeah, thank you. Today, again, we played very good. And happy we scored goals. And again, very happy and satisfied the contribution, attitude, desire, what our players showed today. And that's the only thing I can ask them day by day. They show this on the training field. They showing this in the games. So, yeah, very pleased. Good game.
Jā, šodien atkal spēlējām ļoti labi. Esmu priecīgs, ka guvām daudz vārdus. Un esmu priecīgs arī par to vēlmu un attieksmi, ko komanda parādīja. Un tas ir tas, ko es varu prasīt no komandas.
Which goal you like the most of today's match?
I like all. I have to say, there were some beautiful goals. There was, first goal penalty. For me, it was a clear penalty. Then combination goals, Pekka, good shot there. I love all of those goals, you know. Good the striker scoring, all three strikers scoring, so that's good for them. And as I said, it, for me, every goal is beautiful goal.
Riga now have many players who can score from the penalty spot. Is there any hierarchy or it depends on the situation?
It depends on the situation. It depends on the situation and I want to feel during the match who is kind of inside the game. And then we decide when it happens.
There was a lot of fun, a lot of moments in second half from both sides. Why it's happened on the Riga side? Why Jelgava had many moments in second half?
Of course, it was mostly after 75 minutes when we made a couple of changes and the game came a little bit too open and we started to force things too much. That's the thing, you know. We wanted so much to score more goals, and as always in football, when you try to go quick there, it comes quick back to you. And what we did very good, 65 minutes, 70 minutes, we keep the patient, we made this one extra pass, made opponent move, and then there was a space. And then even if we lost the ball, we were much better positioned to start our counter press. But now this last 75 minutes, we try to go too big, too early, too big, too stretched. And then when we lost the ball, we were totally open and Jelkava, then they have a space to attack, which they didn't have first 70 minutes.
Both Costa Rica players came in the second half, Gallo and Contreras. How good shape they have now?
Of course, about Contreras, he spent, you know, this spring, you know, with the Pafos, not played as much as he wanted, you know, so it's never easy. Went with the Costa Rica, with the Copa America, did not play as much as he was hoped maybe. So with Tony, we all know Tony, how good he is, how much effort he puts every time. But we know also that he's not close yet, you know, how good he can be, you know, match fitness-wise, to connect with the different players, he will come. And then the new boy Gallo, he played this Copa America games, so he has a match fitness. Now it's just to get used to circumstances, get used to new players, but I think everyone saw today that we have a good footballer.
As I see, Skonto Stadium is preparing for European battles. How team, how you as a coach are preparing for Slovensk Wroclaw?
It starts tomorrow morning, the preparation. From now, this on, we concentrated this Jelkava game. Now, it's a beautiful night, Wednesday night here in Skonto. So the preparation starts tomorrow morning, and it will be difficult but exciting football match. And it is a game. Whole club, of course, is waiting. All the players are waiting to be participate, and that's why it's actually nice moment now, because we are in a good shape. We have a lot of players now getting, you know, their good shape. So this is the game we can really look forward. This is the game we know that we need to play a very good game. It's a two games, you know, as we know, home and away. But it is a definitely European tie we can get through, but we need to be close to our best.
So you will not spend this evening watching how Wroclaw plays in the Ekstraklasa?
Let's put it this way. I have a very good staff, and you know, they will watch it, and you know, I will get the report, and then I can watch it more calm tomorrow and more analytical way, because sometimes in my crazy head, it's, when I look game live, I get too much involved, you know. So I let my staff prepare, and then I watch it, and then we come with a good game plan for Wednesday.
As I saw, there is changes in staff. Ivans Visotskis is out from the club. What happened?
I think it's a normal football club, normal football, new challenges, and this, yeah. He did, and I think he has done good many years, you know, very, very good job, and very good professional, very good person. So I wish him all the best for his new challenges.
So it was his decision, not yours?
No, not mine. No. Of course, you know, as I said it, he was very good what he did.
And the other guy with big challenges, with big experience in Riga, Antonis Černomordis, game number 200. Wow. How you feel about him and the team as a captain?
He's a captain by reason, because I think he has grown a lot during these 200 games here in Riga, and to play 200 games for Riga, it's not easy. And to last these 200 games for the team, who will change so much, you know, during the years, and to be a staple player for the club, that tells a lot that he's very good player, he's very good character, and for me, what's the most interesting part is I still see a lot of improvement, a lot of potential where Anthony, you know, he can improve. And now when you get in this position, you get experience, you get these 200 games, you start knowing a little bit better your body, you start experiencing these actions on the field. Actually, you can improve a lot, you know, in these many years. And still, don't forget, he's still a young boy.
We spoke about European nights, but there is also coming up Latvian Cup night, of course, next month.
Yeah, yeah.
But how much do you heard about this opponent, which will be against Riga in Latvian Cup quarterfinal?
As we do our process, we look the draw, we get the draw, and then we know we will play this 18th of August, if I remember right, it's somewhere there. So we still have plenty of football to play between when we get there. And as we said, it's one of this cup competition, it's one of our main competitions. We want to be successful as well. And of course, these games, they are cup romantic, but this is so far away still, you know. So as I said it, now all focus for next Wednesday and for this big European night.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Ah, sorry.
And one question about strikers, because today Reginald Ramirez scored from penalty. Also Antoni Contreras, who returned to Riga. Also Marko Rekža was on the pitch before a match against Śląsk. Will you some headache? Which striker will be playing in the first squad? But it will be a positive headache, because Riga at this moment have three quality strikers.
Yes, and you see, I'm smiling and I'm very, very happy, coach, this moment to have this privilege to have all these top strikers. And you need to remember, we have Niang who scored, we have Makenda who started on the bench, we have Iberico who was there, we have a midfield power who can score a lot of goals as well. So for me, I could not ask more. So if you think it's a problem, I'm so happy to take this problem and make best out of it.
And today Edwards Daškevič didn't play. Why? Because he didn't play against JFK Ventspils, and he didn't play today. He will be ready on the match against Śląsk.
Let's see. It's with him. He got little something after Liepaja match. He has been rehabbing very, very much. Today he already made a bench to feel it a little bit. So, as I said, we take it day by day, and to get Daškevič back, it makes us stronger as well. But as I said, you know, it's day by day.